Do you want to know how to use time boxes with TeuxDeux? Find out in this week's new series of Working with Time Boxes, I think. Hello and welcome to a brand new series of videos that I'm going to do, which is showing you how you can set up my time boxes, or time boxes, not really my time boxes, but setting up time boxes in many different productivity apps. And this week, as the first one I'm going to show you, I'm going to show you how to set this up in TeuxDeux. That's TeuxDeux. This is a wonderfully minimalist to-do list application. It is designed for the person on the go, somebody who just needs to see what they have to do today, and just by a simple tap shows that it's actually been completed. It is very simple. For those of you who like tags and project folders and all sorts of other stuff, to-do is not for you. This is a really simple minimalist application. And I want to show you how, and it is actually perfect for setting up time boxes. And I want to show you how to do that today. Now, before we go any further, I would just like to point out that no, I am not planning on leaving Todoist. Todoist is my go-to to-do list manager. I have no plans to change that in the future, long-term or short-term. But what I really want to do with this mini series is just to show you guys a few different options, but still being able to use a wonderful, simple organization structure for your to-dos. Okay, without further ado, let me take you into TeuxDeux right now so that you can see for yourself how you can set up time boxes in this wonderfully minimalist app. Right, so here is the basic user interface of TeuxDeux. And what I really like about this app is that it is incredibly simple. Now, essentially what you have is you have two sections in TeuxDeux. You have the bottom section where you can create your very own lists. So you could create a shopping list, you could create a project list if you wish, you could create whatever you want. Now, obviously in this, what I want to do is to show you how you can set up your very own time boxing system in TeuxDeux. So what I've done is I've created the project folders, if you like, at the bottom. So we've got this week, next week, this month, next month, and long term. And essentially what I've done is I've just dropped the tasks in here. In the top section, you have the days of the week. So you've got Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, because I'm recording this on Thursday. So I've got this here and it shows me the previous day. So I can actually just have a look to see any tasks that I have completed the day before. It's kind of, you can do it like a mini review of the day. So what I would do in this particular case is I would be looking at this week and I'm thinking, right, when am I going to do these tasks? So here, review next month's travel plans. I'll do that on Friday. I can drop that up there. Drop termination agreement for Dr. Lee. I'll put that there. And invite Strangways for drinks on Saturday. So I better do that today so it gives him a few time. Review maps of Crab Cree. Oh, I'll do that on Saturday. Organize transportation. I'll do the both together. And get follow-ups up to date, we'll do that on Friday. And essentially that's all you would have to do if you were doing your weekly planning session. And this is one of the things that I absolutely love about TeuxDeux. Now, it's the perfect minimalist to-do list. There's no bells and whistles, there's no labels, there's no context, there's no project folders. Essentially you have what you can create down here, and you can create additional ones here. What I would want to do if I was using TeuxDeux, I would actually like to keep all my tasks at the bottom. So I would just have this week, next month, and long term. That's how I would organize it myself. If you wished, you could create a project list by just clicking this T here, and you can create project list. And you can actually just create your own projects if you wanted to keep them there. Personally, I don't want to do that. I just want to keep this nice and simple with this week, next week, this month, next month, and long term. But essentially then you can just drop the things in here. Now, I have just removed all my to-dos because I refreshed the page, but you say you can just drag them up here. And on a big screen, this works really well. And the iPhone app, which I'm afraid, I don't believe there's an Android app, but on the iPhone app, you can actually just create you just get to see on the iPhone today's date. And if you don't do any of the tasks, what will happen is they automatically move forward to the next day. So it's a really, really simple, very, very easy to use to-do list manager. Maybe not for everyone, but if you are truly looking into a minimalist to-do list manager, then the most minimalist I've found, except for say just a simple text file, would be this to-do. It's just a wonderful, wonderful application for those of you who are into the more simplistic things. So let's just imagine that, okay, I've removed my travel plans for tomorrow, for the next month, and I've done the termination agreement. As you can see, all that happens is it grays out. Now you do have a few, let's say you do have a few editing options. You can use markdown text, so I can do the two stars here, put the two stars there, and hit return, and then I get this bolded. If you wished to be able to use your 2+8, you could do it that way if you wish. Personally, I probably wouldn't, and I would try and minimize the list because it's just showing 10 tasks, and as you go through them, you get them done. And I can say, right, I'm having a really good day. Let's say we're going to next week. I just move along here. I can go into next week by doing the stars there. So I've got, just go back one day, Monday, Tuesday. So I can actually start doing, I will call Jamie about the walk. I need to do it on the 25th. So let's do that on Tuesday. Just put that there. And let's just imagine that I don't want to forget that. So I'm gonna bold that. So I'll just do the markdown text and make sure that that comes up. So we'll do the two stars and then hit that. So that comes up there. I need to investigate Professor Dent's laboratory, or we'll do that on Wednesday. And you know, this is just how easy it is to manage your tasks as and when you're doing it. Now, the only thing that I've found is that you can't specify when you add a task. You do actually need to be in the app, and you need to actually go into the actual list to add a task. You can email a task to yourself with to-do, and that just will then send it to the task to today, and then you can reorganize it from there. But essentially, it's just dragging and moving things around. If I don't do this task, let's go back to this week. If I don't do these tasks, they just automatically move forward to the next day. So it's actually a really simple, easy to use to-do list manager. And if you don't want a lot of bells and whistles and you just want a simple to-do list manager, then have a look at TeuxDeux. It costs about, I think it's about $25 a year. It's not too expensive. And for what you get, I think it's actually worthwhile. It's been around for a long time. I don't see many reviews about it, but as I was looking at different to-do list managers that could operate the the time boxing organization structure, then TeuxDeux is definitely a contender for something that's really simple and very, very easy to use. Okay, so there you go. That is my little quick review on how to set up my time boxing organization in TeuxDeux. And maybe for you, those of you who are a little bit on the fence about what applications to use, then perhaps this is an app that maybe you want to consider. Well, thank you very much for watching this episode. It just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week. Thank you very much for watching this video. Now, I have a question for you. Are you ready to go beyond the to-do list? Now, the reason I ask that question is because your to-do list is never going to do the work for you. Your to-do list is only ever going to show you what needs to be done. And that often can cause a lot of anxiety, a lot of stress, and a lot of overwhelm. What really helps you to get your work done, and what really helps you to become much more productive, is developing your own workflow. A workflow that you work from every single day that makes sure that you stay focused on the things that you have identified are the most important things to you. Now, that could be your work, it could be your goals, it could be your family, it could be your personal life, it could be your self-development. Whatever that is entirely personal to you. But the key is to develop the workflow so that you are consistently making small steps towards achieving the things that you want to achieve every single day. And that's why I have developed my Productivity Mastermind course creating your very own custom workflow. And I would love for you to check out the course. The course is available now, details of which are in the notes below, and I would just love to see you in this course. So please join me in the Productivity Mastermind course, developing your very own custom workflow, because this is a course that's going to take you way beyond the to-do list so that you start to really move forward on the goals and the things that you have identified are important to you. Thank you very much.